a rhythm, just a whole different vibe. And unbelievably, with improv and working with the greats, Will Ferrell and, you know, and all that kind of stuff. And Danny McBride. And so this was interesting in the case of I've been, you know, doing that. And coming into this, it's just, it's more of a different rhythm, basically. You know, so you just have to kind of, you know, as an actor, you just kind of exercise your atmosphere and environment. And you're like, all right, this is where we're at. Let's morph into, you know, that kind of role. So you kind of, you know, come and go. You know what I'm talking about? So, yeah.
What did you learn from doing that?
Well, I'll tell you that y'all gotta tune in on September 26th.
Okay.
So it's good times.
Okay.
I can't say much. What did I learn from Danny? He could not be more of a gentleman in real life.
Really?
He could not. Honey, he is giving you geniusness. He is one of my favorite people, and he's absolutely incredible and talented and so kind and gracious and just an unbelievable talent.
I have a couple of diet and fitness questions. You look amazing.
Thank you, honey.
You're welcome. So what is your number one diet trick?
Okay, I don't do the diet thing. I am from the South, and I'm a meat and potatoes girl. So basically, you know, after I hit 20, I used to be able to eat anything I wanted. And I guess it wouldn't show or something. After I hit 25, that changed. I'm just a big fan of, like, I love cuisine and love to eat down, but just moderation. And I know, like, so many people say that, but, like, it doesn't matter truly. And I think what's so interesting, you know, with this whole thing, when they were talking about the weight and everything, it does not matter if, like, you're small, tiny, large, or big. Everybody deals with food in one way or another, do you know? So I'm a big fan of just, you know, just moderation. Eat that chocolate cake and then, you know, not eat a chocolate cake. You know what I'm talking about? Just like whatever you feel, but just everything in moderation, you know? But you shouldn't let it have power over you, basically.
What's the food that's always stocked in your kitchen?
Okay, well, my boyfriend, my boyfriend's Bobby Dean, which is, you know, Paula Dean, who's giving you Food Network. I don't cook, you see. He does, and it's incredible. So many different things, burgers and macaroni and cheese and, you know, I'm a big sweet fan. Love me some sweets. I don't know, everything. Salmon, hot dogs, just, you know.
Is there one food you just can't resist?
Krispy Kreme donuts. That is my vice. I love it so much. Yes. Oh, and I love Mexican food. Adore, and Italian. Is there, basically all.
Is there a favorite snack?
Thanks. What? Thank you, Diane. Favorite snack, honey. I'm such a girl that, like, whatever I'm feeling in the day, like, you know, running with my emotions, that's what I'm gonna go get. Like, if I'm craving a cupcake, we gotta get a cupcake. If I'm craving, like, carrots, let's eat carrots. Like, I'm not ritual where I'm like, I'm gonna go get my Kashi bar, which is, Kashi's amazing too. I adore Kashi. But, you know, so.
You may have already talked about this, but are we not gonna see you on Eastbound and Down this season?
You gotta tune in. Yes.
You can't say anything.
I can't say that. you gotta tune in. It's gonna be amazing. Okay. An amazing, amazing season coming up. So I think it's September 26th. Yeah. Yes. Of course.
What's it like working with Chuck Lorre again?
Well, you know, I've met him back in the day in September last year for 2.5 Men. And it was kind of just the most incredible meeting in the sense of they believed in me to play the role of Betsy, just this guest spot for, you know. And they came up to me that first guest spot and they said, you know, what's happening and want to kind of know my background and everything. And they were like, well, we have something in mind. And I said, lovely. Well, you come calling if you need me, do you know? And so that's how it came about. Kind of one thing happened to the other. And it's a dream, darling. It's an absolute dream.